was fighting Vilmar Fernandez, and he got leg cramps, and he couldn't fight back. And if Vilmar had been more aggressive on that evening, he would have been champion today. Kenty went down with the cramps that were so severe and the pain was so acute. So he shook him out and really got through because he didn't have but a couple more rounds to go.
There was another situation. This fight is coming up now shortly, and Larry will appreciate this because Angelo Dundee was in the corner the night that the then Cassius Clay defeated Sonny Liston for the heavyweight championship of the world when Liston in Miami Beach sat on his stool with a broken shoulder.
Si cada vez que vas a pagar con un cheque...
Sí.
Ahí está el puertorriqueño Carlos de León. 27 victorias, una derrota, un empate, 21 de sus triunfos por la vía del knockout. Estará enfrentándose a Marvin Kamel por el campeonato del peso crucero, versión del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo. Será esta la próxima pelea que estaremos llevando hasta sus hogares. Y quiero repetirles que Telemundo, conjuntamente con Producciones Rafael Fusaro, estará brindándoles el próximo sábado y domingo combates de título mundial. Matthew Saad Mohamed frente a Lottie Mail el próximo sábado y Eddie Mustafa Mohamed frente a Rudy Kopmans el domingo, en ambas ocasiones comenzando a las 10:30 de la noche. Son estas las próximas presentaciones de boxeo que tendremos para ustedes, donde habrá un título mundial en juego.
Son dos buenas peleas y esperamos contar con sus compañías nuevamente.
La escena se está preparando ya para el combate entre Carlos Sugar de León y
Marvin
Kamel. Y hay que señalar que esta es una pelea que ha estado buscando por mucho tiempo ya, desde hace varios meses, Carlos Sugar de León.
He's going to be in there defending his crown, and he's got a good left hand. So it's going to be interesting to see how Squire Daly handles this young fighter in this championship event.
Ahí está el campeón. 36 victorias, 2 derrotas, 2 empates, 16 de sus triunfos por la vía del knockout.
El boxeo está llegando ya a ser como la lucha libre, un gran espectáculo. Aquí tenemos a Marvin Kamel luchando un tocado de
pluma. Sugar de León from Puerto Rico, the number one contender.
From Sugar Ray to Sugar De Leon, Larry.
I can tell you something about Marvin Kamel. He's a proud champion. He wears his belt around the lobby. He wants to be recognized. He wants people to know who he is. This man is coming out here to fight tonight because he wants everybody to know that Marvin Kamel can fight and he is a champion.
Here he is entering the ring. And Kamel has fought 40 times with 36 victories. Only 2 losses, 2 ties. Let's go into the ring. And here's Cam.
Before announcing the final contest, on behalf of Don King Productions, we would like to thank you for your patronage here tonight in the Louisiana Superdome. The final contest of the evening is a battle for the WBC Cruiserweight Championship. Officials assigned by the WBC are referee Senor Carlos Padilla from the Philippines. Judges Roberto Ramirez from Puerto Rico, Ray Solis from Mexico, and from our own native United States, Lucian Jobat. Presenting the challenger from Rio, Piedras in Puerto Rico, weighing in tonight at 182 and 1/2 pounds, Carlos Sugar De Leon. De Leon, the champion of the cruiserweight division. Weighing in tonight at 180, Indian Marvel Camel.
And there they are, Marvin Camel, the champion, and Sugar De Leon, the challenger from Puerto Rico. And we are now in the final bout of the evening for the World's Cruiserweight Championship. The referee, Davila from the Philippines, who I think worked your last fight, Larry.
Yes, sir. No.
He did the one in Montreal,
yes,
didn't he?
Yes, he did.
He did the one in Montreal with Leonard and Duran.
Davey Green, Las Vegas, worked my last fight, I think.
You were busy concerned with the other fella. You weren't too concerned with the man in the striped shirt.
That's right.
De Leon and Camel.
This is going to be a very good fight. These guys are going to be fighting. Last time I seen Camel, he was doing a little holding and whatnot. Let's see if he get out of that this time.
They're both punchers. Camel has posted 16 knockouts, and De Leon has 21 in his 29 fights.
El tercer hombre en el cuadrilátero lo será Padilla de las Filipinas, Roberto Ramírez de Puerto Rico será uno de los jueces, Rey Solís de México será el segundo oficial y Luza Jobar o algo parecido será el tercer juez en el combate.
El árbitro no vota, votan los jueces nada más.
Correcto. Primer asalto del combate, pactado a 15 por el título del peso crucero versión del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo.
Camel backpedaling right at the outset. Some heavy leather being thrown.
If you notice, Sugar De Leon, he comes to fight.
Yes, he do.
We may have another war on here.
Yes.
These are some good matches, that's one thing.
They certainly have been balanced.
Knowing Sugar De Leon, he's coming to fight, so it's going to be a war.
Sugar había indicado antes del combate que iría precisamente a este tipo de pelea que hemos visto en estos pocos segundos. A presionar, a poner presión. Sobre el campeón.
Pero Sugar tiene una determinación fiera de llegar a ser campeón. Tiene ante sí un buen campeón, un hombre que pega también.
Shakes them off well.
You got that right hand cocked up there too, like Duran did. He's always ready to go. Sugar De Leon, I'm talking about.
De Leon, because of course Camel is the left-hander now, the southpaw. Counter wheeling left and right.
Zurdo Marvin Camel.
And again, in a bizarre evening, he slipped.
Stepped
and tripped
on his
over
toe.
His foot.
Stepped on his toe.
Literally.
Buena izquierda ahí.
Well, we've had a man in this corner, a man trip over a board.
No, ha habido problemas con la lona.
Now he stepped on the
good up on the lona.
Right,
right,
right, right to the
right. To the body and to the head.
De Leon hit the combination that
he's trying to win this title.
He's got Camel a little concerned.
Camel comes back with a good left hook, though. Sugar De Leon, he wants that title.
Sugar De Leon in the red trunks, harassing the champion Marvin Camel in the early going. Still on that move, left and right, missing a left and missing a right. Then landing a right on the glove was Camel.
Good
gets caught
good,
in the corner,
good
however.
Good punches by Sugar De Leon that time.
De Leon, very impressive, Larry.
Yes, he is.
Started an uppercut, held up. Takes a left to the ear, boxing his ear.
Yeah, it was sort of a slap punch.
A nice right, short jolting right by Camel. Backs away from De Leon's left hand. This is the Cruiserweight Championship of the World, round one. De Leon in the red trunks, Camel in the white.
Camel is very awkward, and De Leon don't really know how to figure him out yet. He's just trying to stay right there with him and put pressure on him and count him with punches.
I wonder if he's fought many southpaws.
Right hand to the body.
Camel's corner, Bill Presents.
Segundo asalto del combate.
Man, and he's telling Marvin to fight a little bit more.
De Leon keeping the pressure on him, but you'll notice that Camel very dead to get away from the punches on the ropes. Now he ties him up.
De Leon is going to stay right there.
En el primer asalto fue el hombre que llevó la ofensiva.
De Leon with a, you can see the animation at the weigh-in today. He was a very excited guy and very happy to be on this card tonight.
Yes, he is. He's a good fighter. You know, I've watched him come up all the way in his career, and he's always been a guy that stays right in there, very tenacious and determined.
And he works on the body of Marvin Camel. The southpaw is the world's champion from Missoula, Montana. Now it's Camel with a couple of the body.
Yeah, good shot.
Maybe Camel's taking lessons from De Leon. Maybe saying, if he hurt me with the body shot, I might can hurt him with one.
You live by the sword and you die by the sword.
That is right.
Late in round number two, De Leon against Camel.
Camel's
left
throwing
and right
him.
Combination by Camel.
Camel is throwing him. He says, you're not going to get my title.
He's the southpaw. Takes one on the point of the chin. Ties up De Leon.
Good counterpunch. Good right hand. Good right hand.
Stays on top of him.
Dos buenas derechas de Sugar De Leon, una al corazón.
He's coming to fight. He's, like I said, he's proud. And he want to hold on to his title.
De conquistar el título sería el puertorriqueño de mayor peso en cuanto a un título mundial se refiere. En poseer un título mundial.
Right to side of the air,
el momento de honor corresponde a Chigui
Torres.
Superdome en New Orleans.
Le déjame decirte, hasta este momento De León está ganando la pelea.
Cruiserweight Championship of the World.
Llegado a los mejores golpes ha sido el hombre más agresivo de todo el tiempo.
Sugar De Leon of San Juan, Puerto Rico. Chasing the champion.
Nuevamente los problemas con la lona.
When Camel circle around the ring a little bit, it looks a little bit off balance to me.
Y es una esquina neutral la que está rebalando.
With something, it might cost him.
La que se supone que no sea
16 knockouts.
Tan peligroso.
Oh, that was a low blow.
That was below the belt line.
That was lower than the belt.
Hard right by De Leon on the set. But only we three saw it. Nobody up there saw it.
Sugar De Leon is fighting though. He just looked down at me and gave me a wink.
He sure did.
He's not worrying about low blows or anything. He says, I'm here to fight.
Yeah, he wants that title.
It landed.
Estamos en el tercer asalto.
De Leon against Camel.
Mira, hasta este momento va Sugar De Leon camino de un campeonato a menos que el campeón no haga algo. Pero hasta este momento Sugar De Leon ha dominado.
They're moving around the ring now. De Leon keeping the attack on him.
La pelea iniciando, claro, pero hasta el momento De León ha sido el hombre agresivo en todo momento en el cuadrilátero, tratando de convertirse en el campeón puertorriqueño número 11, y sería el título mundial de boxeo número 13 para Puerto Rico, ya que dos han logrado dos títulos diferentes. Se trata de Wilfredo Benítez y Carlos Ortiz, que triunfaron Carlos en el ligero y en el welter, Junior Welter, y Wilfredo en el Junior Welter y en el welter. Sería el campeón de mayor peso en cuanto a Puerto Rico se refiere, en el peso crucero, donde menos peso hemos tenido como campeón es en el peso gallo con Sixto Escobar y Julián Solís.
If you notice De Leon and you notice Benitez, Wilfredo, Benitez and Gomez, these guys do not smile when they fight. They got that serious look on their face at all times.
There's a right to the body by Camel.
Good body shot. They hurt. They takes it out of you. But you can't. You got to throw more than one. More than one got to land.
Well, he must keep the pressure on because De Leon was the aggressor early on. Now here late in round three, the champion Marv Camel has come on, working hard to the body.
Oh!
Takes a left and right in close.
Left hook.
Most of the attacking has been to the body.
Yes. Camel looked like he got a little nosebleed from a right hand. Good body, good heart punches they are.
The punches are much crisper now.
This kid grow, he's a very determined fighter. I remember, I never thought he would be a cruiserweight from 130 pounds.
Yeah, he was. De Leon?
Yeah, De Leon.
Yeah.
Camel's nose is starting to bleed a little bit more now.
Well, he ran into a punch on the upper lip, I think. He got hit between the nose and lip there. Somewhere in the lower face, right to the body, Camel. near the end of round number three. Camel and De Leon, cruiserweight.
Good left hook by De Leon. You see that?
He followed up.
Punches like that will pay off.
There's the bell at end. Louisiana.
Don't Estamos forget. Amigos en el cuarto asalto del combate.
Round number four. We had a photographer, lady photographer working all evening too at ringside.
Yes, we did.
En este momento, Sugar De Leon dominando el combate.
Fourth round, Cruiserweight Championship of the World. Marvin Camel, Missoula, Montana, in the white trunks. Sugar De Leon of San Juan, Puerto Rico, in the red.
De Montana, el campeón.
I think
Marvin Camel. Todavía en esta división del paso crucero no hay un hombre que se haya destacado realmente. Lleva muy poco tiempo también de crearlo.
Good right hand there by De Leon.
If you're wondering, they weigh in just over the 180-pound mark.
Another good right hand by De Leon. You know, Camel knows to start bleeding more and more now.
De Leon knows that and he's working on it.
Stand right on top, and like I said, he wants that title.
Y el campeón está en franca retirada.
I think De Leon might be a little bit ahead right now.
And he's pressing his advantage now with that cut lip.
He just can't lose his cool. He got to stay there. He got to stay cool.
De Leon hacia el frente en todo momento.
Good counter by Camel. He tried to sneak one in there on him. Partly blocked.
It was jarring, however. The corner will be called upon to stem the blood flow.
Good.
Buena izquierda ahí de parte de Marvin Camel.
But the glove was kind of open. It really didn't have that much power on it. If it was a closed fist, it would have been better. Little respect now, though, from Sugar De Leon.
Yeah, he's realizing now that Camel's southpaw style can wind up with a couple of bombs. There's another one. He's keeping De Leon off balance this fourth round.
Yes, he is. Left, right hook by Camel.
The champion's having his finest round, round number four. De Leon looks a little bit puzzled.
Good right hand, back with another left by Camel.
La izquierda de Camel está llegando.
The blood is.
Frecuentemente en esta ocasión, en este cuarto asalto al rostro del retador puertorriqueño Carlos Sugar De Leon. Estamos ya en el final del cuarto asalto.
Camel is really working real good this round, but
Camel just hit him with a good combination that time, Don.
And lead and stay on him and keep pressing him and get back into the groove that he was in the first three rounds.
Estamos amigos en el asalto número 5.
We are in round 5. El cuarto fue el mejor asalto del campeón. Pero los primeros tres lo ganó Sugar.
Chasing him around the ring. Look at this.
Muy buena derecha ahí de parte de Marvin Camel.
Look like he wants to take him out now.
De Leon is taking the fight to the champion in the fifth round.
Sugar bajó bastante su mano derecha en el asalto anterior y eso le dio la oportunidad a Camel de llegar con su mano izquierda.
He started out with just a surge and then he slows down in mid-ring.
It's early in the round.
We're in round number 5.
Hasta ahora De Leon ha pegado los mejores golpes, pero Camel lo ha asimilado.
Oh, good and he cuts him with an uppercut.
Good uppercut.
Now you've got a little blood on the lips of De Leon.
Yeah, Sugar De Leon.
Está sangrando por.
I have a hunch, so we're going to see a.
Sabios, el puertorriqueño Carlos De Leon.
This is Marvin Camel of Missoula, Montana, who is the world cruiserweight champion.
And Camel ha estado sangrando por la nariz.
Against Sugar De Leon of San Juan, Puerto Rico, in the red trunks.
La cortadura en el labio.
And he wants that
porque
title.
Un golpe en la nariz fue impide la respiración.
Butting that time, it was inadvertent. Padilla didn't have to say a thing to him, he just tapped it.
He's doing a very, very good job on that.
Excellent official.
Right hand lead, left hand lead.
Left hand lead, that was
now
really
cut under the right eye.
Yeah, right hand. Left hand.
De Leon is starting to show wear and tear. Takes a left uppercut to the body.
I think Camel's experience is going to work for him.
Buena izquierda ahí del Camel.
He's counter-punching very effectively against right. DeLeon.
Yes, he is. He's moving and working. He's working, Sugar.
El dominio que tuvo de León en los primeros tres asaltos prácticamente similar al que ha tenido en los últimos dos de Marvin
Camus. And remember, it's a championship fight.
They certainly are. They want it. They're warring with each other. Look at the punches they're missing.
Them into the balcony.
Man, haymakers.
They want to be known around the world. They want to show the people of the world that they're here to stay.
And don't forget, it's a title fight, which means it's scheduled for 15 rounds or less. This is the round that Sugar De Leon's eyes show them. In the cruiserweight division for the world's championship. On the right of your screen, in the white.
Estamos en el sexto asalto de la pelea hasta este momento. De León ganó los tres primeros, Camel los últimos dos asaltos.
Puerto Rico, Sugar De Leon.
Have you noticed that mouth was suddenly be noticeable on the Sugar De Leon's eye, on his right eye?
That left hand that caught him.
Aparentemente la esquina de León lo ha frenado que pelee en el contraataque. Que obliga al campeón venirlo a buscar.
And coming up with his second win now.
That is right.
Ha salido en este asalto con las manos arriba. Tanto la derecha como la izquierda de Camel en el último asalto. El quinto. Llegaron en forma seguida hasta el rostro del retador puertorriqueño.
Had to reach down and find a second win to come on to win.
Yes, it has many a times that I felt that I could have done more than I was doing. For instance, the Mike Weaver fight when I knocked him out with uppercut. Remember, I said that.
Camel ha recibido muchos golpes al cuerpo, que son los que debilitan a un boxeador, pero no lo veo débil hasta este momento.
I had to reach back and get a little bit more.
Dig a little deeper.
That's right. That's what makes a champion, and this is what you have to do here. And earlier tonight, that's what Sugar Ray Leonard displayed.
He certainly put it in the showcase tonight.
Right.
A lot of activity around the ring, a lot of supporters behind Camel and De Leon. And for De Leon, Don, this is a big opportunity tonight. He'd like to walk out with a belt.
Yes, he would. There's a lot of activity inside the ring. I think him and Camel both are fighting a magnificent fight. Camel has been the southpaw, is sticking and moving and putting his combination together, but De Leon is right on his case.
De Leon cambió, o sea, obligó a Camel a volver al estilo original que le dio el dominio de los primeros asaltos al puertorriqueño.
That's what you have to do when you land a good shot in there and you feel like you're hurt.
That's what Leonard did tonight. He got hit by Duran and come back.
You have to do that.
That body shot.
If you notice Camel's eyes now, he's really bloody now. I don't know where the blood's coming from. I can't see it as yet, but he's really bloody in the face. I don't know if it was headbutt or what.
I notice referee Padilla sees it too now.
Yeah, he's looking at it really hard. It might be over the eye, over his right eye. Good jab by him.
Referee stopping the fight for the moment.
A headbutt by De Leon.
Aparentemente tiene un corte en el ojo derecho. Está cortado en el ojo derecho. El campeón Marvin Camel y Padilla ha detenido el encuentro para examinar el ojo derecho del campeón.
I think under the WBC ruling, if the fight is stopped on the headbutt, the man who's ahead on all scorecards.
Las señales que hizo Padilla me parece que estaba indicando que fue producto de un cabezazo.
Here it is. Let's take a look at it again. You can see it coming right now.
Efectivamente, ahí está la repetición.
They're going to resume, and De Leon.
No es un cabezazo intencional, sino fue sencillamente un movimiento de los boxeadores. Lo llevó a golpearse uno al otro con la cabeza. Fue un golpe prohibido.
Este es el séptimo asalto del combate. Estuvieron trabajando en el minuto de descanso en el ojo derecho de Marvin Camel.
Ministering to his eye, Larry, and they did a good job. He got a good left hook there.
Yes, sir. They did. They did a good job on Camel's eye. And if you notice, Sugar De Leon, they grounded him in the corner to cool him down because I think they bring back some stamina. Good left.
Buena izquierda ahí de Camel.
Sugar De Leon.
You mentioned De Leon and the blood. If you close watching are beginning to think this could be a bloodbath, well, you see it.
Good left hook to the body by Sugar De Leon.
The eye's starting to open up again.
Yeah, and he's throwing that jab now, you know, more prolifically than he did before.
Yes, he's starting to use that jab. And the jab is starting to penetrate Camel's eye.
And Camel must realize that there is the chance that the fight would be stopped. And could that dictate his strategy now?
It could. But I don't think that butt came from that cut came from a headbutt.
No, that was a punch.
That was a punch, and then the headbutt came after,
after
that.
It.
And then Camel did the butting. He was the one that leaned in and did the butting. It wasn't Sugar De Leon that did.
So his championship is dangling right now because of a bad cut. And De Leon, who is has stoked up energy, and he's
got
hit
walking in that time.
Into a punch.
You got to be careful.
We saw a fight earlier tonight.
De Leon está tratando de trabajar encima del ojo derecho del campeón.
Yeah, Ramos is one of my favorites too. I'm glad to see him get beat like that, but this boy
pero Camel continúa muy efectivo con su mano izquierda.
He really caught him with a knockout blow.
Camel is starting to throw desperation punches, which they, you can see him coming for miles, and that ain't no good.
Also tonight, we had a championship retained. Maurice Hope.
Good left, good hook by De Leon.
Maurice Hope retained his WBC Super Welterweight Championship over Carlos Herrera in London, which was seen by many of our viewers. We're in round number 7.
Sugar is more determined now, and Camel is fighting more frantically and more recklessly.
Good punch.
He got a good punch, a good right hand by Sugar De Leon.
His nose is bleeding and his eyes cut.
And he's taking a beating right now.
That body punch hurt. That left hook to the body, you see the frown went on Camel's face.
De Leon is coming on now.
He's very fighting strongly.
He might have got his second win.
Camel is wrestling him now and took him to the ropes.
They'll go 2 out of 3 falls next Sunday. De Leon in the red trunks trying to take the crown away from Missouri.
Próximo a concluir, amigos, el séptimo asalto del combate.
Authoritatively now, he's taking possession of the fight and he's making his fight.
Camel on his feet, ready to go. Here they go.
Octavo asalto del combate.
Round number 8. Camel in white, De Leon in red. Marvin is a champion out of Missoula, Montana. They clinch, one of the few clinches we've had.
This is proving to be a real good fight. This is really something. This cruiserweight title
Luce
fight
que los dos
very
se
good
están
fight,
cansando.
Donald, and they got 15 rounds to do it.
Yes,
7 more rounds
el
to go.
El avance que hizo el campeón Camel
justifiably so.
En el cuarto y quinto asalto se ha detenido luego de que De León dominara
at his ultimate.
Los primeros asaltos.
Action personified all night long in the
principalmente luego del corte que sufrió Camel en el sexto asalto.
You can hear him in the background. They're either with De Leon or with Camel, and they're all the way with their man. Right to the ear.
I'm telling you the truth.
Camel with an uppercut, and now he has bloody De Leon's mouth again, Larry.
Yes, he's getting
hit. Oh, what a good jab that De Leon hit there. That was a real stiff jab.
Good counter by Camel also, Donald.
De Leon Camel
got to, De Leon got to watch that.
They're both administering damage now.
Yeah, they're punishing each other.
De Leon in the red trunks. Camel in the white.
How do you see the fight? I got it even so far.
I don't think there's very little between them. I agree with you. I think that De Leon won the first couple of rounds, and all of a sudden Camel in the middle rounds. De Leon came back to win a round, and now here's Camel again.
I think it's Camel's punches is kind of lazy, though, now. They're not going in with the sting that they were going in. He just seemed to just be using his arms rather than his body and putting the power in.
I have a hunch that the body attacks have worn both men down. De Leon especially right now, seemingly fatigued against the ropes. He didn't want to look at him.
He's resting. He's on the rope resting, and which that's a bad thing to do.
And Camel's sensing it now. And he's starting to
repetimos que Sugar Ray Leonard obtuvo la victoria. Knockout técnico en el octavo asalto sobre Roberto Durán. Y luego del combate, Durán anunció que se retira definitivamente del boxeo.
They're fighting, though. I have to get
They certainly are, boy. They really are fighting. This is a great championship fight.
And it brings credit to boxing to see two men
Oh,
away
look
like
at that left uppercut.
De Leon might have been playing possum over there.
Looked like he was.
He just wants to win. The desire is there.
Esta pelea luce como que la resistencia es la que va. Que
really using his weight to every advantage he can by just making his body wear De Leon down.
A miss as Camel ducked under a wild swinging left hook.
Que pueda soportar a su rival encima de él durante más tiempo.
If you notice both corners, they doing a job working. They have their hands full working on both fighters.
And they doing an excellent job.
Larry, I'll tell you, they're working overtime.
Estamos en el salto número 9.
Both been cut repeatedly. Here's a follow-up right and another right.
Está cortado del ojo derecho y bastante hinchado del ojo izquierdo, Marvin Kamel.
Yeah, they're fighting. They want to win this.
Oh, he messed with a right hand. He shook his head in disgust.
Sugar DeLong, yeah. Takes one that time.
Could they overdo the job of putting Vaseline on his face?
No, they can never overdo it, putting Vaseline on the face. It protects the fighter. Yeah. The judges don't want that, but it protects the fighter. I like
All right.
to see it.
There's the uppercut by Camel, the champion, from Missoula, Montana. His trunks formerly were white, but they're rapidly approaching the same color.
If you notice Sugar De Leon, he could take a good shot because Camel had hit him with several hard punches, and Sugar De Leon's still there. And on the other hand, the same way with the other guy.
Camel is waging a war of uppercuts this round. A lot of is the vision affected at all by all of that on their eye?
No, but like I said before, it really bothered them. They can tell the puffiness, and it looks to me that his eye is starting to swell up a little bit, and that's starting to bother him a little bit.
Both eyes.
Both eyes.
Both these men tomorrow morning, when they get up and look in the mirror, will know they've had a fight.
Yes, they will. And I think everyone that is witnessing this fight will know they are having a fight.
One thing about it, when they get on that airplane tomorrow, everybody's going to tell what they are.
There'll be no hiding it.
No hiding it. But these are fighters. This is their trade, so they do the best they can. They are here to win. They are here to entertain people. Those good counter punches
the
right there.
The punishment to the body, you can feel it.
Right.
There's a left to the neck and then a
wild right
left
hook.
Carmel.
Left hook.
Camel throwing left hook. We're late in round 9. A 15-round cruiserweight championship of the world.
De Leon is starting to lunge in now. That's bad. You cannot lunge in like that on a champion. He's
Quite
very smart.
Used to do that, didn't
he? That's right.
That
used
leaping
to lunge.
Left, right.
Leaping left hook, but that's no good. You get caught in the midair.
Good night, Irene.
Right.
Oh, that was a good shot.
Look at the eye bleeding again.
Yeah, he put him in a good combination there.
And the left, which was the third blow
he
of that combination,
that.
Put the eyebrow again.
He's ready to leap again, De Leon is. He's ready to leap with the left hook.
And he's getting caught for it.
He's not worried about getting hit now. He's just walking in, just taking punches to land one. He's ready to throw another left hook.
Décimo asalto del combate. Y la ventaja para el puertorriqueño en los últimos asaltos la ha logrado ampliar, a mi entender.
Mi opinión también, Junior. Yo creo que Sugar De Leon, a pesar de que los dos están cansados, luce más entero que Camel.
De Leon is still walking in, not worrying about taking punches, just the land one.
Southpaw style of Marv Camel.
He's starting to bleed again.
Yeah,
too.
The bleed is coming down that right cheek from the eyebrow. And much of round 10 still to go. So he's going to be the recipient of some punches.
Estamos en el asalto que constituye la parte final de la segunda tercera parte del encuentro.
You got to watch both guys' heads because they're
going to be in the recta final. Correct.
They leap in there, they lunge in there.
Butts are very, very probable now.
At that was
on or about foul territory.
Yes, that was a little low that time.
I think so.
But they do it intentionally. They're so hot. They want to win, and
El león tiene mejor reflejo que el cambio.
The adrenaline's flowing, and particularly, well, for both men.
Both, yeah, they're both excited. They're fighting for the world's crown. And one has it and don't want to give it up, and the other one wants it.
So it's not a small prize they're in there bleeding for.
This is a very interesting match, Don. I think it was put together very good. The champion have his hands full. The people got the money worth on this fight.
They certainly have. Ha logrado pegar bien a De León y no le ha logrado hacer daño en realidad.
Que De León le debe haber ido restando vitalidad a Camel en su puño por los muchos golpes que le ha pegado al cuerpo.
If you notice, them body punches are starting to hurt Camel. He's starting to flinch every time De León throw one in there.
Oh, he's wincing now. You're right.
El trabajo de Padilla como tercer hombre en el cuadrilátero ha sido excelente. Próximo a concluir, amigos, el décimo asalto de este combate por el campeonato del peso crucero. Versión del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo entre el campeón Marvin Camel de Montana y el retador de Puerto Rico, Carlos Sugar de León.
And you'll notice there is no let up either.
La campana, amigos. Vamos al asalto número 11 del combate. Y es de aquí en adelante cuando los que están abajo, o estiman que están abajo, echan el resto.
De León, who looks angry.
Y queremos repetirles que el próximo viernes estaremos nuevamente con ustedes a las 10:30 de la noche presentando el combate por el título mundial entre Matthew Shad Mohammed y Lottie May. Y el sábado también a las 10:30, Eddie Mustafa Mohammed frente a Rudy Kopman. Con las próximas carteleras que estaremos llevando hasta sus hogares.
And Camel seems
Camel to be en estos momentos sin rodilla.
Solo pie. Bueno, sé que lo hubiera notado.
Can't push this guy off. This guy's taking this punch and keep coming.
He's strong now.
Remind me of Joe Frazier right now. Take him.
Vulcan Joe. And the eye has been slit again. The blood is pouring down.
Coming right in there, taking him and giving him back his combination.
It's a big moment for De León.
Sería nada raro ver a De León en estos momentos noquear con un golpe abajo. Camel está sangrando nuevamente del ojo derecho.
También puso la reversa.
What other guy get off?
I don't think he has the energy to counter like he was. He ain't as sharp. He's just moving now for survival.
I think De León has
When he do punch, he's just slapping him and just swinging him in there.
And De León is landing crunching punches now.
Stalking him like a killer.
Look at that. Right, one after another.
No respect for Camel now.
No, he's throwing bombs now, and he's not worried about getting hit.
Camel takes a good one to the body, but De León comes back with a good uppercut.
Sugar ha bajado sus dos manos.
He has the fight going his way.
No tiene respeto alguno ya por el campeón, aparentemente.
You can taste the title now.
Good counter by the Camel there.
Camel's coming back with
the 11th round.
You can see the blood coming out of Camel's nose.
De León is stalking. He's looking for the white opening now. Bingo, the trotty sword with the left.
De León is putting everything in every punch, even the jabs he's trying to knock you out with.
That eye is bleeding, the nose is bleeding, and the lip is bleeding.
Camel is worried now.
You can see it in his face. He's still fighting, trying to dig and pick his punches. Oh.
And he has another one in close.
Yeah, right to the nose, right to the nose.
Blood coming out of both mouths.
Oh, he's a bloody mask. And his
León también ha pegado bien.
To stem the flow of blood.
A través de todo el combate.
Another right. Good right.
Buena derecha. Segundo final ya, amigos, del asalto número 11.
I would say that Camel is on the brink right now. Young Sugar De León.
Bueno, ya los últimos cuatro asaltos.
Es
la opinión que Camel va a tener que apretar bastante.
Well, Brown.
He's working. Look at him.
Looks serious.
This is dynamite now. They're both throwing dynamite.
He looks serious.
luce fuerte aún. León. Por lo menos se ve con unos paseos fantásticos.
Se ve cerca del campeonato y eso es un estímulo tremendo para cualquier boxeador.
Yeah, but De Leon's leather begins to open it up again. Look at that.
Yeah.
He's starting to take him. Sugar De Leon of San Juan, Puerto Rico, trying to take the title away from Marvin Camel of Missoula, Montana. This is for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World.
It's an exciting fight, boy, and especially so for a southpaw, because they usually tend to have dull fights.
And there hasn't Camel been a dull moment in this one.
Not a one.
Camel just landed a left hand.
Camel's come back in this 12th round. We had him on the brink, but he's fighting. Look at this.
His trunks is all bloody.
Oh, yeah. Camel's trunk. Those pants are now polka dot.
Good counter by De Leon that time.
And there goes the nose again as the blood begins
ahora,
to flow profusely.
Luego de ver ese movimiento de Camel, de tener arrinconado por completo a Sugar, no iniciar una ofensiva, y tiene que estar consciente de que está abajo en la pelea. Me parece que se acerca más a un campeón.
Creo que Camel está muy cansado. Se nota que está cansado. Además, los golpes al cuerpo. Y el cuarto de los golpes al cuerpo lo ha recibido él limpiamente. O sea, ha sido golpe efectivo.
De Leon in Camel's corner now.
Oh, look at them shots he's taking.
Camel just—he's
landing.
Landed a couple good shots, but he took a couple good body punch by Camel. But De Leon come back with his own.
Lo detuvo con una derecha.
These guys are really mixing it up in there.
We're into the end. 12th round. Even a backhanded punch and an uppercut by Camel and a left hand, all by Marvin Campbell, as De Leon misses a long left. Camel getting the best of this exchange.
I think Camel came back some this round.
Indeed he did.
Yeah, he's really worn. The resiliency and the recuperative powers of these guys is tremendous.
He reached back for that little extra we were talking about.
And that's what you need
when he needed it. Hard right to the left of the body, and now De Leon is punishing him again.
De Leon is throwing hard punches. He's not
full of action tonight, though, Don.
Asalto número 13 del combate.
Go tonight. We have had excitement, excitement, excitement.
It certainly has been. It's been a tremendous evening of boxing. I can certainly say that. And the cards that I put on are so controversial, you never know which way they're going to go from one extreme to another.
That's right. If you notice, Marvin Campbell, now he's come back out dancing. He might have got a win. I don't know, but
he caught a left hook there.
I'm telling you.
He gets on his horse backwards.
He came out dancing. He's bouncing around. Is he trying to get another win?
This is round number 13. 15 rounds for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World. And this is De Leon, the youngster from Puerto Rico, raining punches on the fighting champion, Camel.
De Leon wants every one of his punches to count now.
He said he can do. He's methodic now. He's very calculated. Punching with authority.
And he's wasting very few punches.
Yes, it is that...
We were talking about Padilla having refereed in Montreal the first Leonard fight. Here he is tonight.
Well, he's an excellent referee. He refereed my first fight in Manila, you know, in the thrill in Manila. He was in the center between Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali.
Now, that was quite a fight.
It was a classic.
I think he also did the one in Las Vegas between Spinks and Ali, huh, Don?
Yes. It was a good shot.
Marvin Camel of Missoula, Montana. Two rounds from hopefully defending his title tonight against the young man from San Juan, Sugar De Leon in the red trunks. And I'll tell you, if Camel retains his title, he will know he went to war tonight.
He certainly will. This is going to be a very difficult fight for the judges, you know, because both of these guys are throwing a lot of leather.
If Camel win and go home and tell somebody, they'll say, you won?
I'd hate to see the loser, yeah.
I'm telling you. It's very interesting to see, and it looks like it's going to go to distance.
Yeah, he looks like he's been in a meat grinder. from all the leather thrown at him.
I only had to go 15 rounds one time, and let me tell you, 15 rounds is one
long journey.
One long journey to go, I tell you.
Right to the solar plexus by De Leon. Then a left
hook. And if you know this, Sugar De Leon, this is his first time going 15 rounds. So he's really showing a splendid determination and ability here.
And an awful lot of stamina, both of them.
And that's what you need in here when you're fighting. I don't care if you go 3 rounds, you need stamina. These guys are taking punches and they're throwing punches. You can't take nothing away from these guys.
Well, this is an excellent fight.
Round number 14 for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World.
Asalto número 14, amigos.
Like he's gonna put it on this round.
Bueno, el campeón tiene que apretar si quiere retener su título. Pero hasta la fecha, mi juicio, de León está ganando la pelea.
No cabe duda, ha dominado muy bien. Lo más que pudo hacer el campeón fue lucir en el cuarto y en el quinto asalto. De ahí en adelante, prácticamente todo ha sido para Sugar De León.
Los mejores golpes los ha pegado De León.
Campbell got to be feeling no punches. He's taking good shots.
He's still taking them, but he keeps on moving.
Y en estos últimos asaltos,
actually, you have to feel
Campbell ha logrado llegar de lleno al rostro de Sugar De León, que podría ser quizás la mayor preocupación en estos momentos. Un golpe que enviara la lona al puertorriqueño. Pero ha llegado y no ha lucido como
con efectividad.
Correcto. No ha lastimado al retador.
Bueno, en la esquina de Sugar De León está Bill Daly, que aunque no ha vivido 1,000 años, conoce 1,000 años de boxeo. Y yo veo que la táctica ahora con Sugar De León es dejar que Kamen lo venga a buscar, presumo yo, porque está seguro de que está en ventaja.
El viejo zorro,
sabe mucho.
That's right. But if you go by the bruises that are on each other's face, you have to go with Sugar De León.
That's right. But here's Camel fighting back in the late stages of round 14.
If you notice, Campbell punches now, they're landing, but they're like slaps, and nothing really on.
They don't have the force.
Les repito que el próximo viernes estaremos nuevamente a las 10:30 de la noche con el combate.
Whoa, what a right hand that was. He's taking a lot of punishment.
Entre Matthew Saad Mohamed y Lottie Mail. Y el sábado también a las 10:30, Eddie Mustafa Mohamed frente a Rudy Kopman.
Punches are raining on those faces.
Good right hand again by De Leon. He's getting confident now. You can see that. Got his hands down.
I think he feels he's got his man now. Lands a crushing left. Takes a right, but again it's a slap. Lunging at Campbell, who ties him up.
He's punching him hard though when he punches, and Campbell is doing a good job of trying to stay away, but he's really a gruesome.
He's having great difficulty warding him off now.
Yes, he is.
El último asalto, amigos, número 15.
Bueno, si este asalto sigue el mismo patrón de los anteriores, tenemos un nuevo campeón mundial.
Bombs away for the Sugar Man.
Good right hand by De León.
He's really connected with his punches now.
He's winging now.
Campbell's trying to counter, but he's not succeeding at it.
De León's looking down.
Sigue Latinoamérica. Perdió un campeón, pero está a punto de
he's banging the camera up with both eyes. Blood is starting to come out now all over.
He's really got inside. Everybody
sería el campeón número 11, el puertorriqueño número 11 que logra conquistar un título mundial en el deporte del boxeo.
That was a swing and a miss, and he's up ready to go again.
Esa actitud de cámara ahí deja claro que no está ahí para dejarse, para tirarse al suelo con un golpe. Va a terminar de pie. Buena izquierda ahí de Sugar De León.
Campbell still fighting back, though.
Yes, he is.
He's a gallant champion, even if this is to be a losing effort for him.
He's really fighting. This is really tremendous.
Look at him come back. You've got to hand it to the veteran like that.
He's a champion, like I said. It takes another champion to beat a champion.
Well stated. And there are two of them in the ring right now. Boy, they're banging away. No quarter asked by either man.
Neither one. It's really a war here.
You know, look at
super fight.
The referee Padilla, his shirt is spattered with blood.
You got about a minute and 10 seconds left.
Of non-stop action,
non-stop.
Brent.
Non-stop. They really working. Don, you really did a job today.
Thank you, Larry. This really is a super fight, and I'm very happy about this. These guys are really, it's really closing the show.
It's a great way to close the
show. Yes, it is. This is a good way to close the show. It's been an exciting evening all night long.
Good body punch inside.
Yeah, that shook him up. That shook him up.
Yeah, he's hurting. This is De Leon ducking as Camel keeps on coming despite the terrible physical beating he has undergone. His eye bespeaks it.
The seconds are counting down.
Yeah, they're coming down on him. Look like it's going to be a new champion here.
We're in the final moments. But
again, that's up to the judges.
Sugar De Leon of San Juan and Marv Camel, the champion.
You got less than a half a minute to go, and Sugar De Leon is still forcing the fight.
They're still pounding away. You haven't seen Camel let up either, despite the beating.
Camel's really been fighting back, but he's not fighting back with any sting. He's just in there now, trying to survive.
And he's having trouble seeing.
Both of these guys are going to have to take a long, hot bath tonight.
There'll be no fight for a week either for either one of them.
I'm telling you. Both will be sore.
I would be shocked.
Bueno, estamos en espera de la decisión de los jueces y no debe haber duda alguna. Puerto Rico consigue un nuevo campeón.
No veo cómo le puedan quitar la pelea de León porque fue el hombre agresivo.
Ahí está la decisión oficial.
Your attention, ladies and gentlemen. WBC scoring supervised by Duke Durden. Judge Roberto Ramirez scores Camel 142 points, Sugar De Leon 145. Judge Ray Solis scores Camel 145, Carlos De Leon 145. Judge Lucian Gerbert scores Camel 141, De Leon 145. Winner by majority decision, Carlos De Leon, a new cruiserweight WBC.
Well, let's
champion
we
of
got
the world.
A new champion for Puerto Rico there.
Yeah, we got another champion.
Two new champions.
Bueno, amigos, la victoria para el puertorriqueño Carlos Sugar De León. Roberto Ramírez dio la ventaja al puertorriqueño Sugar De León, 142-122. Rey Solís de México dio el combate empate, 145-145. Y Luce Jover de los Estados Unidos dio el combate 141-145 a favor del puertorriqueño.
Yo creo que es más bien el voto de Estados Unidos el que decide el combate a favor de Sugar De León.
Ha sido un verdadero placer el poder estar con ustedes esta noche brindándoles estos dos combates por el título mundial en que Roberto Mano de Piedra Durán sucumbió en nocaut técnico frente a Sugar Ray Leonard, mientras que Carlos Sugar de León pues logra obtener la victoria y coronarse nuevo campeón mundial.
Bueno, para nosotros los puertorriqueños hemos tenido la oportunidad de ver no solamente una pelea histórica como es la de Durán y Leonard, sino también ver a otro compatriota proclamarse campeón mundial de boxeo.
Y el hombre de mayor peso, en cuanto a los puertorriqueños se refiere, que logra conquistar y poseer un título mundial. Les recuerdo que el próximo viernes estaremos nuevamente con ustedes con otro combate más por campeonato mundial en producción de Telemundo conjuntamente con Rafael Fusaro. No se retiren, en breves Telenoticias en acción. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.